In kinematics, we observe the motion of some object. To describe motion of somebody, we need some parameters. There are many, like position, displacement, distance, velocity, speed, acceleration, etc. So let's start with the very basic one, position. We know how to describe position, right? Like this white ball is on the right side of the blue ball and to the north of that yellow ball. Imagine there is nothing except that white ball. Then how do you describe the position of it? You can't. To describe position more precisely, we use the concept of reference frame. We choose three mutually perpendicular axes. Here we named them as X, Y, and Z. Now we can describe any position. For an example, to reach at the position of the white ball, we need to move 5 units towards the positive X axis, 6 units towards the positive Y axis, and 4 units towards the positive Z axis. So now we can describe the position of that ball with 3 numbers, 5, 6, and 4. These numbers are called Cartesian coordinates. In vector form, we can also represent it as 5 I hat plus 6 J hat plus 4 K hat, which represent the vector R from the origin to that point. That R vector is called position vector. Here I hat, J hat and K hat are the unit vector along X axis, Y axis and Z axis respectively. There are two points on XY plane, A and B. Assume that a particle moves from A to B and it can take any path to reach at B. Length of this path are distance. But there should be one path which is shortest and a straight line. The length of that straight line is displacement. So remember, all possible paths can be considered as distances, but the straight one is displacement. Displacement is a vector, as it always points towards the destination, no matter which path you did take to reach there. Thus can be represented as an arrow, and the length of that arrow represents the value of the vector. Be careful with the naming convention here. The vector is AB, as the direction is from A to B.